and gentlemen, please stand for our lovely bride. Please be seated.
Where's my Henry?
Where's Henry?
Henry!
We need Henry's assistance.
Come here. Just a little hair mess up.
Thank you, Henry. Good afternoon, everyone. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. We are gathered here today in the presence of family and friends to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, to give recognition to the worth and the beauty of love, and to add our best wishes and blessings to the words which shall unite Peter and Tara in the loving bond of marriage. Now, we come together not to mark the start of a new relationship, but to recognize a beautiful bond which already exists and will continue to evolve with time. Now, our bride and groom would like to thank each and every one of you for being with them here today and for supporting them through everything it has taken to make this day a reality. This day will primarily be about celebrating the love between Peter and Tara, but it would not be the same for them without each and every one of you here today. You are all a part of this story, and today is a day about stories and togetherness. Now, for my bride and groom to stand before all those that you love most in this world and to promise to love another person openly and trustingly without limits or preconditions for a lifetime is perhaps the bravest thing that a couple will collectively ever do. Now, this is undoubtedly a promise you've been making over and over again, but it is also a promise for us all here to bear witness. Now, what I want you guys to always remember throughout the good and the bad is that your marriage is created by friendship, respect, and love. As our bride and groom bring with them the dreams which drew them together, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure to be shared, and they both bring with them the amazing abilities to view the world, themselves, and one another with incredible senses of humor. And as any married couple here in our audience can surely attest, you're going to need your sense of humor in marriage at times. Now, love itself is a miraculous gift, and a wedding is a celebration of that gift. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what we're all here to do this afternoon, as we are gathered together to be overjoyed for and with this amazing couple who are so wonderfully suited for one another that it is pure delight for the rest of us to see how overwhelmingly happy two people can truly be. This is where I'd like you to smile for the crowd, please. Now, when we think of love, we often speak of two people who deserve each other. Well, not only do Peter and Tara deserve one another, but they're genuinely a perfect match. And their marriage, far from being something they had to work at to achieve, was inevitable. Now, today, promises become permanent, and friends become family. However, this is not a day about the words spoken or the rings exchanged, nor is it about grand pronouncements. Today, the day of Tara and Peter's wedding day, is about love. And there are many types of love, almost if not all, that are represented here today. There's romantic love, the love of parents and children, of brothers and sisters and family, and finally, the love amongst friends. And not only do our bride and groom love one another romantically, you can see it in every look, every moment they're together. They also love one another as friends. In fact, throughout these last few years together, they've also been cultivating an incredible friendship that is the backbone for this relationship and this marriage going forward. Now, in addition, the love collectively found here today from family and friends will help support the promises these two will make momentarily. All of us here today, in some way, shape, or form, will help solidify this bond as you are joined together as husband and wife. Now, your new journey together will be at times richly rewarding and at other times difficult. But most importantly, it will be a journey you take as one. Now, the peculiar thing about a New York State marriage license is that it only has two spaces that are reserved for witnesses. And yet everyone here today in some way, shape, or form has been a witness to the amazing benevolent aura that personifies this couple's relationship. Harkening back to the very first date, I'm reminded of Tara's words when she told me I could instantly tell that he was a true gentleman who was very interested in learning about me as a person as opposed to physical attributes. There was an instant ease when speaking to him. No nerves whatsoever, which is unusual when meeting someone for the first time. I remember never wanting that night to end. Now, in echoing very same statements about his soon-to-be betrothed, Peter painted the picture of them both growing closer together so effortlessly, seemingly finding the last remaining piece of the jigsaw puzzle after a 42 and a half year search. Now, it did not take long for Tara to realize what she had felt for Peter was something she had never felt for anyone before. Just a mere 5 months into their relationship, our couple decided to take a trip to Jamaica. Now, Tara told me Peter had not even uttered the words, "I love you," at this point, but she recounts with great fondness how excited she was to travel across the world with this man and how this is something she's always admitted she never would have done with anyone else at that juncture in the relationship. Now, their sense of values, undoubtedly instilled in them by their respective families, are rivaled only by their senses of empathy and compassion. Now, it has often been said that the most lasting legacies we leave in our children are the values that we instill in them. For this and so much more, our bride and groom are especially thankful for the role and their impacts their families have had and will continue to have on their lives going forward. Within our couple's dynamic, compassion resides within those actions, both prodigious and modest in impact. From the unequivocal support they give to each other to chase down their respective individual endeavors, to those seemingly little gestures done on a daily basis. Those random surprise treats purchased by Tara for an impromptu Yankee playoff party, or those spur-of-the-moment Chris Stapleton concert tickets. This relationship, ladies and gentlemen, is also typified by an amazing sense of perspective, which enables our couple to truly place the value they've had on one another's lives. Now, in describing the indelible imprint that Peter has left on her life and her heart, Tara went on to tell me, "Pete shows me he loves me in so many wonderful ways each and every day. And one of these ways is by encouraging me to surmount my procrastinations. Without his love and support, I may not have ever opened up the doors to my private practice in 2016. Now, ladies and gentlemen, to know this couple is to realize what a truly incredible partnership they've cultivated with one another over the last 5 years. Well, almost 5 years, right?
Correct.
With each part of the relationship seemingly being complementary to the other. As a couple, they balance one another out in so many wonderful aspects of their daily lives. And I'd be remiss if I did not mention they are not only uniting with their own hearts together, but also joining their two families as well. Their daughters, coincidentally, with the same June 1st birthday, or their sons of the same age. Yes, they reiterated this anticipation of starting their very own version of the Brady Bunch, minus the Alice, of course.
Yes.
And Sam, I would imagine, too. Now, whether they're out exploring new restaurants to quell their inner foodies, making memories in Anguilla, or simply having a few drinks at home belting out Hall & Oates lyrics as if their lives depended on it, the true beauty, ladies and gentlemen, of this relationship is they found so many wonderful ways to be themselves and to be together at the same point in time. Quite frankly, folks, they just simply get each other and are looking forward to all those adventures that have yet to be written within the pages of their lives. Please join hands and look at one another. Now, all marriages do begin with the giving of your word. You cannot assimilate your lives and hearts without giving your word, and such giving must be unconditional and true. For in joining yourselves to one another, you link yourselves to tomorrow, the unknown, and the ever-changing seasons of life. And so it is, Tara and Peter, that we now bear witness as you solemnly swear to pledge your love and life to one another in the form of these vows. Now do you, Peter, take Tara to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And do you, Tara, take Peter to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, for richer or for poorer, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Now the marriage ring seals the vow of marriage and represents a promise for eternal and everlasting love. Now the ring itself is placed on the fourth finger of the left hand because it was traditionally believed that this finger was a direct connection to the human heart. Now your wedding ring is also a symbol of your promise to each other. And just as the shape of the ring of the circle is infinite, strong, and simplistic, so too may your married life with one another always be. Let these rings serve as a perpetual reminder that you are both part of something infinitely greater than your individual selves. A beautiful bond you've both crafted on a strong foundation of trust, respect, and friendship. I'd now like to introduce the best man, Robert, for the presentation of the wedding rings. Now, Tara and Peter, before I pronounce you husband and wife, I have one more thing I'd like you to do. I'd like you to join hands and look at one another. Now, your wedding day is a very fleeting day by nature. It's a day that flies by in an instant. And many people here remember that very same characteristic about that wedding day, their own wedding days. So with that thought in mind, I'd like you to think about the happiness you're experiencing in front of all these people that you love. Disregarding the motorcycles, of course. Now, what I want you to do is think about your life 10 years from now. That's a lot of planning, Tara. Now, we all know your visions for the future may not always be identical, but they would truly be complementary. And it has been said, a dream you dream alone is only a dream. A dream you dream together, that is reality. And for our bride and groom, that new reality starts now. May the blessings of life, the joy of love, the peace of truth, and the strength of spirit be your constant companion now and always, as I pronounce you husband and wife. Peter, you may now kiss your bride.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. With song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Congratulations, sir. After you guys, please.